I again am leaning towards Oklahoma in this one. I actually think that this one's going to play out a lot closer. I think if you give Gary Patterson a second chance at a team, he's one of the best coaches in the country, and he's going to be able to put together a good scheme. I think this one's going to play out very closely. I think it's going to be a tight game, and when it's a tight game, I usually just say, all right, then which team has the best player on the field? That makes me lean towards OU with Baker Mayfield being their quarterback. So I'm leaning OU. I'm reserving the right to change that pick once I do a little bit more research this week. But yep, I'm thinking the Sooners are going to win this one.
He's been called a magician, and rightfully so, because he escapes messes. He throws at arm angles and from spots on the field to other spots on the field that other guys can't get into, and try to replicate. He's had an exceptional season, and for me is the Heisman Trophy winner, regardless of what he's done in some of these extracurricular activities, both on and off the field. Baker Mayfield has been the best and most important player in college football for a team that's vying for a conference championship and then a national championship. And certainly in this one, Big 12 officials wouldn't tell you this, but they got to be rooting for Oklahoma as well, because they are the sure bet to get the college football playoff. TCU would need all sorts of mayhem elsewhere. All right, Taylor Midkiff from the LGG joining us to break down TCU and Oklahoma. Taylor, we appreciate the breakdown. I hope you feel better and get ready for the game. 11:30 start locally. That's another thing that television wreaks havoc with. They want the Big Ten playing at night.
Right.
The Big 12, I'm guessing, and Fox try to avoid the SEC game at 4 p.m. So you've got a game in the Central Time Zone that's got to be played at 11:30, I believe, local time, and that's not necessarily what the players and coaches want. If you've ever been around sports, they like the later games, but these two teams are going to have to wake up and get ready to play football.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. I'm going to be interested to see what the crowd looks like for that game. It's I actually heard that already this week, over 3,500 TCU student tickets have been sold, which is not a huge number, but when you consider that that's almost half of TCU's student body, that's kind of impressive. And so I think there's actually going to be a pretty good turnout. Again, 11:30 isn't the best for ensuring that you have an awesome turnout, but I'll be interested to see how many fans are there inside the massive Cowboy Stadium.
All right, talking Big 12 championship game, TCU, Oklahoma, with a winner, if it's the Sooners, getting an automatic, what we would almost consider an automatic bid to the Big 12 championship game. Taylor Midkiff from the LGG joining us to break down the Big 12. Taylor, we appreciate the time and the breakdown.
Thanks so much, Mark. Have a good one.